Hello guys, welcome again to another chapter of El Sótano del Brujo. After a long year of break, and well, you guys know why, I have finally managed to get some time to, you know, go back to make the videos about all of the things that I love, especially Dungeon Crawl Classics. And of course, all of the things related to all of the things that I enjoy. So again, after this long break, you know, I have so many things to talk about. I like so much. There is so much I want to talk about. It has been quite a hectic year. And well, there's no need to talk about it. 2020 was a bit hard to a lot of us. And, you know, I just decided to, you know, make this video, try to be as informal as possible when talking to you, and just try to get back with all of the wonderful people that even today keeps writing back to me and sending me such awesome messages, sending me encouragement to keep making the videos. And I said, you know what, why not? I mean, finally, after the pandemic has been lifted in some countries, it's not as hard as before, things are going back to normal again, so you know, I can finally have some free time to focus on making these videos and try to contact again with all my friends and people that follow me on my small YouTube channel. So I decided to today that I finally managed to make some time to, you know, sit back here at my computer and just talk to you guys. And today, after a long time, I mean, I don't know where even to start, you know. So much stuff to say, you know. It's been an amazing year in some regards. Not everything has been bad, so I will focus on the positive. And one of the positive things has been that I have finally migrated fully to Discord, to play in Discord and in Roll20. And well, I know that probably a lot of you already know about this, but you know, for me it was like a huge discovery, because if you have been following my channel for the past year, back in 2019 I started the channel because I managed to finally get in touch with a DCC Road Crew program and try to go to my local gaming store here and tape some of the sessions that I ran publicly there. And well, some of the videos are here in the channel and you can see them. And well, it was fun for me, extremely fun. So I decided to, you know, start making videos about the things that I love the most, which is, you know, role-playing games. And I think that it's one of the things that you guys love as well. And well, this is me again after such a long break. And I hope you enjoy what I'm about to say. Well, to start, you know, again, I have to say a big hug to all of the wonderful people that keep writing back to me in the YouTube channel, in Reddit, and in Discord as of now, saying that, you know, that you guys like the videos and that you guys like to hear me rambling on and on, you know, for almost for an hour, perhaps hour and a half, talking about, you know, just a lot of things. And some guys have told me that they also like listening to some of the weird ideas that I have and recollections that I have, and well, I don't know, I feel rusty, so so you watch me and well, if you are listening to me and I feel like I'm a bit off, yes, I'm a bit off. It's I don't know, it's like my first video in a long time, you know, because well, there's no need to say it, but the 2020 was a bit hard for me. You know, well, for a lot of us, I mean, I'm not the only one with that. Well, I had to focus a lot on trying to work and trying to make a living here in Panama, and you know, I didn't have much time to you know, to sit back and enjoy life as usual, you know. So I had to leave this behind and for a bit, and well, but things have been going back to normal slowly, so I can now begin to have some free time, and so I can talk to you guys about, well, about RPGs. And specifically today I decided, you know what, I'm going to start my first video of the year, and after such a long break, about things that I have enjoyed a lot amidst all of this chaos that has plagued us all. And for me it was like a simple discovery, you know. I finally found out the joys of playing online, okay? So I was the guy that was a bit like old school, and I was a bit of a dinosaur because I really enjoy sitting with people, you know, at a table and seeing their faces and being the dungeon master that is in front of everybody. And well, it was a bit of a shock for me when the pandemic hit, and then I had to forced to be here at my house, and I was no longer able to go play. And well, for me, how can I put this in a solid way that you guys can understand? For me, it was quite a shock, you know, not being able to go out, especially here in Panama, because the curfew was very strong, was very hard. And well, I felt like at a complete loss, you know. I mean, like, oh my God, how am I going to keep playing if I just can't go out and everything's closed down, and you know, there are roadblocks with police, and in Panama it was a bit hard because a lot of people, I don't know about this, but we had like gender segregation here. Like some days only males or could go out, and other days only females, and well, it was a bit hard, you know, especially for me and the family. And well, it was like a bit of a shock to a lot of us, especially here at the house and with my family. And well, it was an extremely shocking year. No need to talk about that anymore. But just to tell you that's the reason why I was away. And well, thanks goodness, right now I think things are coming a bit back to normal again. And if there is something positive about all of this, is that, like I was telling you about, I was like this guy that didn't want to try online gaming. I was this guy that, you know, I prefer to see people physically and see their faces and go to the store and play and be social, you know. And well, it was, well, quite a world-shattering experience to be completely tied here in the house. And again, there was something good out of this, and it was that I finally managed to break that fear, because I believe personally that it was like a bit of a fear of doing new things, you know, because I was so used, to playing with in a table. And for me it was, wow, I finally decided, because, you know, I wanted to keep playing, okay? And I know that a lot of you might relate to this. I wanted to keep playing, and for me the only option was going online. So I slowly decided to first to go fully into Discord. For me, Discord was mostly like a place to be in communities that shares some of the interest in some of the games that I play in computer. And well, I finally decided to make like a small private server for me and invite some of my real life friends there and see if we could work something out. So that's how I started. And then a couple of friends told me, you know, why don't we go into Roll20? It has like some neat features, and it's completely free if you don't want if there is only like a small group playing with you. And I said, yeah, sure, why not? And well, it's been like a whole year. I've been playing, to be honest, I played more online last year than than the past few years physically with people, because I usually was only able to play with people in the store like once a week or once every month. But here in online, I can now play with a lot of my friends. Now I managed to get like a solid group of my real life friends to play with me. And about, we usually play like two or three times a week. And well, it's in that regard, it has been quite a positive experience for me. And this leads me to why I decided to start this video, because today I want to talk to you. I want to talk to you about the tools of the trade. You know, I really like that phrase, tools of the trade, for a dungeon master, for example, or a judge or a game master. It doesn't matter the tag that you want to place yourself if you are the game director. And for me, one of the tools of the trade that I have found most useful right now playing online, which is also like the future, you know, as life is, can be so uncertain, times and schedules, you know, it's usually better to play online. I mean, you can play from your own house. You are probably in an environment that you feel comfortable and safe, and you can play online and meet new people and play with them, and you can switch around, hop around between games and experience something completely different from the classical experience of going to a local store or trying to convince some of your real life friends or family to play with you. And well, for me, that was like the most, I have to admit it, that it was like a shocking revelation. Because, you know, I was like extremely adamant in not doing it because, you know, like I really liked the old way. I mean, deep down, I personally still prefer it. But you know how the world is, and most of my friends are not even here with me physically in the country. Most of them are spread around the world. So I said, you know what? I'm going to fully embrace online gaming in role playing, and you know, try Roll20, because I mean, that was the first option. I know there are several other options which might be as good or even better than Roll20, but you know, I stuck to Roll20 and managed to get a pro subscription there. And some of my friends even bought some of the core for 5th edition because they wanted to try 5th edition. I said, sure, why not? I mostly play Dungeon Crawl Classics, as you can see. You know, it's the game that I truly prefer. And for me, it's like my core game. I have several videos explaining why I enjoy Dungeon Crawl Classics over other traditional role-playing games. But my friends, you know, said, Jorge, we really like Dungeon Crawl Classics, but you know, let's try something different. Especially when I finally managed to get some of my players to level 7 in Dungeon Crawl Classics without too many deaths. Okay, so only of the original guys, there are only a handful of the original characters. So they, since they have died a lot, they had to make some new ones. And well, I mean, they finally got like a, it's a big long campaign, DCC, that I managed to play with them, and they decided that it was enough. And I said, sure, let's try something else. And again, like the whole purpose of this video in trying to go back into the channel and talking about the things, I mean, I have so many things to talk about, but I decided to make it simple. You know that if you have been following me around, you know that I really like to talk. I ramble a lot. Some people might like that, others not so much, but you know, you have been warned. I'm going to talk a lot and I'm going to ramble a lot. So be warned. If you don't like that, just put a stop, because I really, really like to talk a lot. And I hope that you enjoy what I'm going to say. No? So for those that want to keep listening, I was thinking, you know, I want to go back to the channel, want to make a new video, and I think something like about the tools of the trade of an online dungeon master or an online judge or an online, you know, storyteller. You're a game director, you know what I mean? And for me, it has been like a boon, an extremely great boon, being able to create my own maps. And why? I mean, even in DCC, where I usually, you have been following my old videos about this, I usually do not use many maps. I only use visual aids and try to do a theater of the mind type of play. But when you play online and perhaps people are not really watching you, or at least through a camera, it's not the same. You know, I find that having a clear map of where the players are really helps a lot. And of course, in games like Dungeons and Dragons 5th edition, it's even more helpful because it tends to be more of a token-based game. so that you can actually see where you are located, do some special moves and something like that. It even helps a lot more. So for me, during this year, I found that making my own battle maps, making my own overland maps, is extremely helpful in helping my players visualize where they are, what they're fighting against, and their position in the world. So I decided to show you some of the tools that I use. Some I rarely use, not so much. Some I prefer over others. And this video is going to be mostly about the tools that I use to create my own battle maps, especially in this digital era, where there are so many talented battle map creators. Some guys at Patreon have some amazing works of art. But, and I don't know if this has happened to you, but sometimes you want a map, okay? You want a map that that helps you visualize a specific setting in your head, like in a specific situation. And sometimes some of the maps online usually will not help you with that. Why? Because, I don't know, you want a special room that has, I don't know, 3 floors, or you want a room that has 3 holes in the middle, or you want a small dungeon that has like a pit in the middle, some cages in the back, and a particular configuration of tiles and pedestals and dais, and I don't know. Sometimes some of the maps online will not help you with that. So that's the moment where you had to create your own battle map, you had to create your own overland map, okay, about your own campaign world. And in retrospective, since I have played so much online for the past year and even this year as well, I had come to rely so much on them. So much that for me, it's something that I have to talk about. I have to share with you. And some of the things that I use, because who knows, it might help you start doing your own maps if you are not doing it already, or give you some ideas about some of the software that you can use if you only know about a few of them, or perhaps if you have never ever created a battle map online with a piece of software. Usually, I don't know, you might be a gifted artist and do it yourself at hand, or perhaps you're a budding artist, or perhaps you have no particular talent in that area, but you can draw some basic stuff on paper. But for me, digital is the way, and it has been for a while, but I rarely use it before. I rarely use battle maps before, because I usually, as you can see in some of my videos, I prefer to run modules because they are much easier to run in a local store. And usually I did a photocopy of a printout of some of the special maps that the module has, and that was more than enough. And well, back in the day, I used to have like these amazing Chessex mats that you can use water-based pencils and markers so that you can create ad hoc at the moment like dungeons and walls and stuff. But right now in the digital era, I'm pretty much forced to create something so that my players can understand where they are. And I'm going to show you the way I usually do this. Now, I have to start with something that has been with me for over more than a decade. I have been using it for very specific situation and scenarios. And I must confess, I have like a soft spot for it. And I'm going to talk about campaign cartographer tree. Oh, wow, that sounds funny in English. Campaign cartographer tree. Okay, it sounds funny in Spanish to me. You know that I think in Spanish, but usually try to speak in English to you guys. But it sounds fun. Campaign cartographer tree. You know, if you don't know about campaign cartographer, it's like a very, I'm not going to say old piece of software, but let's just say, because it is continually maintained, it is maintained today. And for me, it has a soft spot because it was the first piece of actual professional, I don't know if I can label it like that, but professional piece of software actual software that I use to create maps. That more or less gave me what I wanted. So without further ado, I'm going to show it to you. Look, this is Campaign Cartographer. For me, it was it was like my very first original piece of software that I bought with my hard-earned money back in the day. It's been with me for over a decade. It's a very robust piece of software, but for me, it's like a monster. And I'm going to show you why. You know, Campaign Cartographer has been with me for so long, and even today, I'm going to confess, I'm not very proficient with it, but I know the basics. I have created some very nice maps with it. And I'm simply going to show it to you because I want you to know what I use. Now, Campaign Cartographer is this. You should be watching it right now. It's like this this particular piece of software that at a glance looks simple, but it actually is not that simple. This is, for example, like a small dungeon that I made in isometric view. And Campaign Cartographer has like a very long history. It is like, this is, imagine, I don't know if you guys know about AutoCAD, but Campaign Cartographer is like an offshoot of AutoCAD. It's like a fast CAD software that, in a sense, it can place any kind of image you want on the field, and it gives you a lot of power. Okay, it gives you a lot of power. Campaign Cartographer comes with other add-ons, which are dungeon, which is the dungeon mapper, which is the one I'm using right now, and there's also an Overland mapper, which I'm going to show you later. And for me, and the main reason why I'm talking about it first, is that it's a bit complex. I'm not talking bad about it because I love it. As you can see, I work with it. I make a lot of maps with it still. And I wanted to show, because not a lot of people use it that I know, but you can make some amazingly gorgeous maps with it. Like I said, this is a FastCAD software. It is extremely professional. It has a lot of flexibility, but it takes a while to learn how to use it. You can create some of the most amazing and gorgeous maps here, and it is so incredibly well done. I mean, I can keep zooming in because since this is a piece of FastCAD software, you can literally rotate on the map any kind of image in any kind of way that you want to place it. And it has all of these contextual menus, and is literally working in a piece of professional software. It has so many quirks, so many ways to do things. It also works with a system of layers that a lot of you guys know, but it has several layers. It has several ways of handling the layers and adding effects to the layers. And I'm only going to talk about it at a glance because personally, I think that people that are starting new into this, into the hobby, and that want to start making battle maps, as much as I hate to admit it, Campaign Cartographer is a bit much. It's a bit complex. If you already know how to use it, I mean, hey, kudos to you, my friend. But even today, I still remember how much I had to bang my head against the wall trying to understand how this works, and how many YouTube tutorials I had to watch to actually learn how to place things. But once you master it, I mean, the limit is simply your imagination and the amount of packs and money you want to pour into it, which is also the second con I see about this particular piece of software, which is that it is expensive. Okay, mine is completely legit. I am not an advocate of piracy, you are so deep, but you want to see that I can let some things slide, especially here in Latin America. But I really like to support creators, and Campaign Cartographer 3 is a bit expensive. We're talking about, I don't know, you can get Campaign Cartographer for about, starting from about $40, and they usually sell it in a pack, which is 40 or 50 bucks for the tree, Campaign Cartographer, Dungeon Mapper. But for me also, it comes with like basic templates, and then you have to keep buying like a DLCs so that you can understand. And some of the DLCs, which are the annuals, the Campaign Cartographer annuals, which is a yearly set of new textures and ways of drawing things. And they're also a bit expensive, really around, I don't know, $20, $30 more. And well, for me, I'm going to be honest, here living in Latin America, earning Latin American wages, it's a bit much. Okay? And why I'm telling you this, I'm telling you to, I'm not telling you to stay away from it, but it's just to know what you are getting. I mean, you can, but you can make some of the most amazing and detailed maps with this guy. I mean, this beautiful monster. It's a beautiful monster. I mean, all of these things that you're watching, I had to place manually one by one. I know how you, I know that most map making software force you to do things one by one, but I mean, like placing the walls, placing the light. I mean, it's wow. It's a bit of a work. It's almost like, I don't know, like I told you, like working actual graphical software for a living, and this is something that has to be a bit more fun, but it is extremely powerful. I mean, besides the things that is a bit complex and it is also expensive, that's the only cons that I see to it. But the rest are only pros. It is extremely powerful. You can create a lot of beautiful things with it. For example, this is one of my isometric dungeon that I launched, that I managed to get to my players in Roll 20. And there are other examples. For example, you can do like something like this. Look at this. This is like a completely black and white map that I made for my players when I was playing Dungeon World, which is something I want to talk to you about as well, because I discovered Dungeon World, which is run by powered by the Apocalypse system setting, rule setting, and it was amazing. And well, I mean, it's gorgeous. I mean, this looks amazing, especially when you export it. I mean, you can export this in such huge formats. I mean, this is like, this is the piece of software that I would use for something that I really, really like, something that I really, really love, and then export it into a big PNG, and then I don't know, make like a huge printout to hang on my wall, for example, because this is practically, this is like professional level software. This is extremely powerful, and I would spend like the whole video talking about all of the good things that this software has. It has a soft spot in my heart, and I have made some of my most complex maps here. When you learn how to use it, you can make amazing things with this. It's well, for me it's fun and a bit relaxing making maps here, and I had to talk about it. I mean, if you're a first timer, you can see some of the things that I have made here and see how they end up looking, and just so that I can show you how the final product is. And I have some screenshots here so that you can see some of the maps that I have made here. For example, this is a fully 100% a made map that I made here in completely in Campaign Cartographer 3. Look at this. I mean, you can keep zooming and zooming and zooming, and you can begin seeing the details of the game. And for example, so one of the things that I really like about Campaign Cartographer is that you can do so many things with it. Some of the graphic sets that comes with it is extremely, they are extremely beautiful. I think this is Chase. It's one of the authors, that you can get like a set of mountains and river sets and stuff that you can then place and do maps with this particular style of art. And the rest is how flexible the software is, that it can let you, for example, a particular set of fonts, and then with this particular set of fonts, you can begin working with them and adding, for example, winding types. For example, I use a lot of TrueType fonts that have a lot of particular things, and this is something that I can do with with Campaign Cartographer, something that I cannot do with other pieces of software, but that does not mean the others are bad or worse, just that they are different. But Campaign Cartographer is something that you can dedicate hours upon hours to try to make maps that are look amazing, that are look especially great. And this, for example, this is something else that I made with Campaign Cartographer. Yes, look, this is the same map. Only that then I just tweak it a bit in PaintNet, but this is the same one. This is the same one. Look, you can see it here, and that's later. And then you can see all of the things that you can create with it. For example, this is like a prison bottle that I created for my players, and once they fall, they usually fall here. And this is filled with a lot of dead people and trash and perhaps treasure. And encounters, special encounters, because there were three ogres here that were waiting for people to fall in the trap. This is like a magical trap. It is like a whole bottle. So like a cursed artifact that you can only get out of it by defeating some of the monsters inside. It was a fun adventure. This is what I did this for Dungeon Crawl Classics, and my players enjoyed it a lot, and it was extremely fun. And I did the maps here with Campaign Cartographer, and well, you can see I can show you all of the things that I have done with this. This is also made with Campaign Cartographer. This is like a dungeon, more like a cave set, like a cave system. And I made it with wonderful beast. And you know, I really love it, but I have to admit it, it's a bit complex to handle. I mean, I don't know if you will be able to replicate some of these type of maps on your first try, but hey, it's extremely powerful. But be advised, caveat emptor, it's complex. How complex? Well, how can I put it? For example, all of the items, there are so many layers. There are so many styles of placing the walls. There are so many ways of changing how things float, especially because, as like I said before, all items have to be placed manually, and then this is CAD software. You have to place them in such a way, and you have a lot of power over them, but then things begin to get complicated. For example, I'm placing here like a bridge. I don't know, I can place it here. And you have to be aware in which part on the sheet you are placing it, because all sheets can also get special effects, for example. All maps, I'm not going to waste more time here, because there are thousands of videos talking about how complex Campaign Cartographer can be and how all of the things that you can do, but it is complex, trust me. Don't want to badmouth it at all. I'm just saying that it can be a bit daunting to people starting. And I'm telling you this because I want you to show what has completely gotten my attention. I'm going to leave it for last. But I have to mention this. I love this. I love Campaign Cartographer. It's something that I can waste hours upon hours. But I have to admit it. When I want a quicker map, I use other pieces of software. I only make maps here in Campaign Cartographer when I totally and absolutely have the time for it. And some of you might not have it. So this is not something to do a quick sketch and then just, yeah, that's it. No. This is something that you have to take with a bit of time and leisure and love it. Okay. But I had to mention it because it has been a staple of my map making habits for very long. But it has been replaced lately by other software. Okay, which I'm also going to show you. And now, this was Campaign Cartographer, and this is me showing you some of the things that I can make with it. For example, look at this. I really enjoy this map. This is a map I made there, and then I finally tweak it once, because this is something else that you can make to make your maps better. You can make it in any kind of software, and then you just open, in my case, I open PaintNet, place the image there, and then completely alter it. PaintNet is like a open source, not open source, but completely free. Image editing tool, so that I can make all these kind of maps. But the basic core of the map, I completely made it in Campaign Cartographer, and it is amazing. I mean, the way the edges, some of the contours of the map, so that things seamlessly move or blend with the map, with the background. I mean, I love it. I completely love it. For me, it's a very powerful tool. And it's truly worth the effort of learning how to use it. But personally, especially in this day and age where I have to do something quick, I am no longer using it, except for very specific cases where I want something more that my players will enjoy more at leisure. Or for example, this particular map of my current campaign world. And I mean, the things that you can do with it are completely amazing. I mean, I love it. I love it. I completely love it. And again, I only use it when I have enough time. So what happened? In this last year, I learned that I usually don't have enough time to completely play the game. I don't have enough time to gather all my friends and then have a quick map. And especially when battle maps on the web usually do not satisfy some of my needs, so I have to make something quick. Now, if you want to make something extremely quick and that is super easy to use, these are some of the other tools that I have, and I'm going to show you this. These are Steam-based pieces of software. This is Illwinter's floor plan generator. I mean, this is what I like about this particular piece of software, which is also extremely cheap. I know, I think it was like $5, $6, $10. I mean, it's no more than that. And it is that you can create, for example, dungeons very quick. You can create them. Especially cave system is extremely easy to use. I mean, extremely basic. And also in Steam, it has a workshop for it. It has a ton of textures, so many textures. Oh my God, there's so many textures for it. It's also super quick and it helps sometimes, especially I mostly use it to make this, as you can see, which is to make small cave systems. It's super easy to use. As you can see, this is all I'm doing. I'm just doing a small, nice cave system here. Right, and that's it. That's all I'm doing. I usually use it for that, for making quick, super quick, and that's it. This is Illwinter's floor plan generator, and I use it only for this. I mean, it has a lot more capabilities. You can make walls, you can make all kind of maps. But again, not my first choice. But for the price, for all the kind of support it has, this is a very solid piece of software, and I also recommend it as well. And it's also super cheap. Now, there's also another piece of software which I rarely use, I must confess. I know it's very good. And it is this, Dungeon Painter Studio. It is very powerful, it's very flexible. I mean, but I'm going to be completely honest with you. It has been replaced by my latest love. I mean, it is very good. Use it if you like. You might find it. It's easy to get in Steam as well. Dungeon Painter Studio. It has a lot of powerful tools. I mean, the guys that make it, they actually respond sometimes there, and they keep it very well supported. Same with Illwinter. And I mean, it's very fun. But also, I mean, once I discovered this particular piece of software I'm going to show you, I mean, I completely fell in love with it. And I'm leaving it for the last. I mean, you know, I was alternating between these three pieces of software, which was Camping Cartographer and the Illwinter's and then Dungeon Painter. And then I discovered something that completely blew my mind. And okay, they're not paying me. I mean, I'm not sponsoring them because any kind of deal or anything, but just because it is extremely, I don't know how to put it. It has been for me wow, it has helped me so much. I'm going to show you, this is what I have found of all these three pieces of software that I have used before, and there are many pieces of software that map. But these were the ones that I used the most, especially Campaign Cartographer, and then until the day I discovered Dungeon Draft. And I think that I made this whole video because I wanted to share to you the love that I have for Dungeon Draft. I mean, how can I put it this simple? I mean, you have seen all of the things that I have shown you, all of these pieces of software that I have here, and you know, I rarely use them anymore. Why? First, because if I want to make an overland map, I usually make it on Campaign Cartographer, because if I want to show a landmass, okay? I mean, these guys also have a landmass generator and mapping software, which is called WonderDraft. I have not tried it, but like I mentioned before, since right now I'm usually playing online and in Roll20, I need a specific piece of a dungeon for my players. And for me, Dungeon Draft has been a lifesaver. I mean, it's cheap. It's already out of beta. It's in version 1.02. And I have been with it for quite a while. And I have even made some packs for it. How can I say this? I mean, I'm going to show you. I should probably make some Dungeon Draft tutorials, but right now I just want to show you about about why I consider this one of the tools of the trade, the most important tools of the trade for me. I mean, you might have other kind of other pieces of software, but for me, Dungeon Draft is extremely, I don't know how to put it. It's, wow. Look, you know, I can make a quick dungeon. I can make a quick underground cave. I can make a quick town if I want. Or surface, a forest encounter, or I don't know. I can make everything super ultra quick here. Why? Because I just, for example, you say, you know, I want to make an email 60 tiles, which is my usual size. Some people use less, but this I do this. Look, then I just make it a Lolo or Tidyfolo assets. I have some. These are some of my assets, but this is more or less what you will see on Dungeon Draft at start. And then you can begin doing anything. You can even ask for the game to create like a random dungeon for you, but I mean, how can I put this? It's so easy to create any kind of map here. It's, wow, it's bliss for me. I mean, you can create any kind of map like right away, especially the way it works. It's extremely easy, super intuitive. I mean, you can make, let's make some water here. I mean, you can make water, you can make for example, these are some of my textures. I mean, you can add textures to it directly by you, and this is what I have done. These are some of my textures. Look, since I really like sometimes working more with look at this, look at the reflection of the water. You can add, it's super easy to add packs for it. There's a huge community group of people making packs for Dungeon Draft. It's so easy to use. I have made, like I told you, several texture packs for it using common use textures. Especially because some of my maps, I really like making them like to be photorealistic, and instead of having this hand-drawn feeling. And these are like simple photo textures that I get off the web, with permission, of course. And then I repack them for people to use. And I mean, I just love it. I just can't create any kind of landmass with this. It's super easy. Super, super easy to do. I mean, Dungeon Draft has been like a boon for me. I'm not going to go into more deeper appreciation of the software, because you have to buy it so that you can see how easy it is to create anything that you want. You can place all kind of items. You can make paths. I mean, this is something that I really enjoy. For example, you want to make a choo-choo train here. Look, you can make like a train set. It's so easy. It's extremely easy. I mean, you can make like a plank. You want to make a plank. A plank way. Look, you can make it as well. I mean, it's like, I don't know. It's extremely easy to use and completely in love with this. And I think one of the reasons like why I made the video is to show you how easy it is, and that you guys go and support these guys and buy the software. I mean, I love it completely. I'm a shill for it. Yes, I have to confess it. It's so easy to use. And you can make all kind of things with it. It's like, look, now I made this map, and then I want to place things on the map, and I can do it. Look, tuck, 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 tuck. Now, when I compare that with this, I mean, for me, you can see why it was like such a huge shock. Because here in Campaign Cartographer, I had to do things slowly, like I have to rotate. Okay, let's grab it here. I have to rotate, then I have to see if I can make it this bigger, for example. Okay, now it's placed here. No, I place it, right? Now, after I place it, I don't want to do that. Now, after I place it, I want to select it. Now, to select, I have to select here in the tool. Da, 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 da. Okay, now I select it. Now, do it. Now, this is me. Okay, deleting, for example. And it's not the same as Dungeon Draft. I mean, no, I don't like this. Okay, I just control C it. No, I don't like any of this. That's it. The other being a FastCat software, for example, it's a bit more complex to do all of this. In the other pieces of software, which are much more simpler, I mean, it's different. I don't want to badmouth any kind of software. I'm telling you, it's super fun. They're super nice. But I have to confess, for me, Dungeon Draft is like a modern way of doing things that I love, that a lot of us have been doing for so many years, and it's extremely easy. I mean, it also has light. This is something that, I mean, I can't explain it. I think I will have to do like a whole Dungeon Draft video on how to use it so that you can see how amazing this is. How amazing this game. And now let's see. So if I want to make, I don't know, some walls. You know, this is I'm going to make some walls. This is it. There's the walls. You can see it. There's the walls. And it comes with a grid. You can also disable it if you don't want it. Okay. You can also say in which particular layer you want all of the particular items you are going to place on the map. And for example, I'm going to show you like one of the maps that I already did for my players, especially when I was playing Dungeon World. If you have played Dungeon World, which is something I have to talk also as well, one of the things that I really enjoy about Dungeon World is how different it runs to most mechanic-based role-playing games. And for me, Dungeon World was the best opportunity to enjoy with some of my role-playing game friends their needs to role-play. I mean, it's a setting, a rule set that forces you to play in a certain way. So for them, I decided to make like a certain maps that more or less fit some of the narrative that I had in mind for the world. So look, I'm going to show you. This is a map I made in Dungeon Draft with some of the black and white assets that I managed to find for Dungeon Draft. And I mean, these maps are amazing. I really love it. I love them. Look at this. I love these maps. It's Dungeon Draft is extremely easy to use. You can make like all of these maps super quickly. I mean, they also have a Roll20 integration if you want to keep the line and shadow. And you are seeing some of the maps that I made with my players in Dungeon Draft. Some of these maps, okay, this has not loaded. Let me see one. I think this one was loaded as well. Okay, yes, this one was loaded. Look at this. I love these maps. This is like a small crypt that has contact with some underground caves, and well, those are monsters that my players kill. But I mean, I really like how easy it is to create maps in Dungeon Draft and how easy it is to export them right directly to Roll20. And well, when I compare it to some of the old mapping software that I had before, I mean, I have to confess, I completely love the way the way Dungeon Draft makes me create a map on the fly. I mean, let me see if I can show you the dungeon generator so that you can see it. Start with the map wizard. Look at this. I love this. I mean, the other mapping software have this ability, but the fact that it is also included in the games. Okay, I'm going to create a dungeon. Okay, how complex? Yeah, sure. Okay, let's generate it. Beep. Okay, look. It's already a fine dungeon here. Like you have the template, okay, and then you can begin like tweaking it at leisure if you want, okay? Sure, I want this, why not? And then you can begin changing any kind of things that you don't like. For example, you want to change the tiles, you want another type of flooring. I mean, the sky is the limit. And I really like the art style. The original, the vanilla art style, but also it comes with a huge set of asset packs. I mean, there's like there are several places on the net that you can get Dungeon Draft asset packs and create all kinds of maps for your needs, especially dungeons. I mean, they are amazing. All of the dungeons that you can create with this, and well, I wanted to talk to you about that. I mean, there's also like. Of course, they will never look like this. For example, this is one of my favorite dungeons which I created for Dungeon Crawl Classics using Campaign Cartographer. Okay, this is something that I have shared publicly with others. I made this in Campaign Cartographer. They will never look like this. Okay, but I mean, it took me quite a while to make this map, like quite a while. especially when you begin to add all of the shadows and all of the special effects. I mean, they look amazing. I really like how they look. And but the amount of time it took me in Campaign Cartographer to make this particular dungeon was, I don't know. I mean, if I begin to remember how long it took me like, I don't know, like, wow. I mean, I made this map in about 3 or 4 days, because I usually do it in bursts of 1 to 2 hours. I mean, in 2 or 3 days, you know, in Dungeon Draft, I could have made like 100 of these maps, okay? And that's something that you have to keep in mind as well. Sometimes, I mean, you want your works to look pretty, okay? You want your things to look like, oh, wow, they look like, they look like from a model, and they look so great, my friend, yeah. I mean, but sometimes, you know, your players, and this is something, I mean, this is like an extra tip I'm going to give you guys. I mean, I wasted I don't know how many hours in this particular map in CC3, in Campaign Cartographer, and so many hours. I mean, so many hours I wasted here. And I mean, my players burned through this in what, in a couple days? You know? And this, it looks beautiful and it's fun, but you know, your players sometimes just want to have something to look at and play. Okay, this is more like, this eye candy is more for you usually than for the players. So you have to keep that in mind. And Dungeon Draft in that particular regard can make things so much easier, because I mean, you can go into Google and say, you know, let's look for a battle map of anything. There are several amazing creations in Reddit at the battle map community. And but sometimes you want, like I said at the beginning, sometimes you just want a map that is more or less fitted to what you already have in mind. And that's the moment where you have to create your own map. And again, I'm showing this to you so that you can see that how important it is to create your own maps, especially when you have like a particular way of like a particular adventure or like a particular campaign that you have in mind for your players. And as beautiful as some of the battle maps available online for free or paid can be, they usually sometimes do not fit your narrative 100%. So you have to sometimes reuse some of the maps, and sometimes you just have to make them yourself. And when the time comes to make the maps yourself, nothing beats for me when you create things with Dungeon Draft. I mean, for example, so that you can see, for example, you know, let's make a new one. So easy to use. No. Let's step back, asset selection. For example, I want to create a sewer. This is from the 2-minute tabletop guys. I mean, they have the sewer. Oh yeah, there is the sewer map assets. Look at this. Let's make a new one. Okay. I mean, let me see if I check the guys. Yeah, check it. Nope. There is only this, and there is only the sewer guys. Let's see here, the sewer map assets, the sewer map tiles, accept. This map, please save and reopen them. Okay. Okay. I mean, there are so many maps here. And what I was trying to do here. You know, I was recording for you guys. I was trying to make a map here, but I mean, there are some of my own assets created here already. There are several of my assets, so that you can see. For example, I'm going to show you some of the assets I created for my own maps. These are my Brewoloco assets. Accept. Please save and reopen. Okay. Yeah, so let me cancel here, because I always forget how to do this. I'm too lazy to do it. the way it has to be done. So let me place all of my assets here so you can see some of the things that I have created. And I mean, when I created these assets for Dungeon Draft, it was made just using Painted. I mean, I grabbed some of the assets which I found on the net that I enjoyed and that had zero issues being shared legally with you. And I just repacked them under a CC BY license. And you will see all of the things that I created. For example, look at this. Some of my assets here. You can see some of the creepy things I liked. This was when I was playing here. This is when I was playing some of my post-apocalyptic radioactive gamma world adventures. And now let's see terrain. Which terrain I'm going to use? What terrain I'm going to use? Okay, look at this. This is some of my terrain. It's something rocky, for example. Hey, why not? Something green. Look at that. I'm going to alter it afterwards. Okay, something like that. Okay. Now the brush, material brush. Ah, look at the paths. These are some of the paths that I made also as well for the game. These are the roads. I mean, look like an old post-apocalyptic. I mean, you can make so much stuff. I think that this is the moment where I'm repeating myself. So again, go get Dungeon Draft. That's all. Having shown here, you are wasting your time here talking about the same thing. I mean, just go buy Dungeon Draft and make maps with it, and get all of the asset packs that you think will be great for it. Okay, and this is my most profound recommendation for you. And especially when you go online, you have to create maps for your players, and I mean, go create them with Dungeon Draft. I mean, this is some of the maps that I have made, and Dungeon Draft can give you so much, especially when you play on Roll20. Look, this is also a Dungeon Draft map. They have so many assets, especially the black and white ones. They are so great. And in particular, if you are curious, for Dungeon World, since the game is so narrative based, I just decided to create a single icon that represents the whole players, so that they could move around. And I mean, when you play online, you lose so much if you were used to play in a certain way. But you also gain certain things that you cannot usually use on a real table. And the maps, especially when you make some interesting maps, some fun maps, it doesn't matter if they are extremely complex maps. It doesn't matter. As long as it shows your players that you care or that you can see where they are, and it doesn't matter what software you use, so much better than others. I mean, maps, especially online gaming, are so necessary. And this is something that I was not forced to create before when I play with people in a real table. But right now, in this virtual time that we are living right now, where you have to play online, you really have to make a map so that they can understand where everybody is. And sometimes theater of the mind does not work so well, especially in some particular ways in online gaming, where a simple map, even a crude one, will help players, because some players really need a way to visualize where they are in the world. And again, I believe this is one of the tools of the trade that people really need to learn how to use right now. I mean, it's, you know, I sincerely wish again that Campaign Cartographer was cheaper and that it was easier to use, but again, once you learn how to use it, it's amazing. But personally, for everybody starting out, just go with Dungeon Draft. You can create everything out of scratch. There are so much good support for it. There are so many asset packs. There are so many things to try. That honestly, I think this is the kind of software that is the modern kind of software that people really need in this day and age to create all kinds of amazing maps for the players. This, I mean, Look how easy it is. So easy. I can create everything so fast. Sorry. And I mean, some other maps, map making tools, they are very good. They are also super easy to use. But I don't know. I really like the way Dungeon Draft works. The way it lets you play some of your own textures within it. I mean, these are my textures, but there are a gazillion textures with all kind of art styles. You know, I really like photorealistic, but you might not like it, but you might want something more fantasy style. And hey, you can do it with Dungeon Draft, so go check it. And I sincerely hope you have liked this video. I think it's time for me to stop rambling. And again, I'm just getting warm up to the idea of talking again for so long, as I have been away for so long. And you know, I'm really excited. I want to try doing more videos and now talking about all of the things that I have played. You know, I have played so much. And not only DCC, but I have played, like I mentioned before, Dungeon World. I play again after so many years, Alternity. If you don't know about Alternity, it's an old role-playing game. And that I enjoyed when I was much younger, and I managed to get all of my real life friends to play back Alternity like 20 years after their own original characters. And some of the new things that I have tried, I have tried 5th edition Dungeons and Dragons. People finally dragged me to try it, and oh wow, I have so many things to tell. I mean, so many things. And well, so I wanted to start with this. Sorry if it was a bit rambly. Sorry if I talk too much. And I mean, it's like me talking to somebody else, to a friend, like to you, listening to me. And you know, I have so much to talk about. So let's leave it like this right now. And again, thank you for listening. Thank you for having been with me through all this time. Some of your messages, especially during the pandemic, were so encouraging, and they helped me pass some of those dark times. Thank you for that, my friends. I read every single message that you guys leave me on my channel, on Instagram, on Reddit. And again, a big hug to everybody. And I hope that you enjoyed this small map making tool video. It's just me warming up, trying to talk about other things. And I mean, what else can I say? I'm glad I'm alive. I'm glad that you guys are alive. And I hope that you are also well. I hope that you can keep playing. And hey, I really miss talking to you, to every single one of you. And I hope that everything goes well with you. I hope that your games, if you're now playing online, your games are extremely fun. And hey, I'm here to talk with you about all of the things that I enjoy, which I think that you guys enjoy as well, which is role-playing games. And well, I think that's it. That's it for today. I mean, it's been fun. I'm a bit emotional about this because, you know, it's been so long since I talked to anybody about role-playing games, because, you know, who else am I going to talk with about role-playing games? You can simply go and talk to people about your role-playing games on the street, because they're going to look at you like crazy. But here I can talk about all of this, and I know that you guys will understand how I feel about that. And well, what else? Hey, thanks again for listening. I will try to keep doing more videos. You know, this is why it's like a small time slot that I managed to get free. And well, again, I hope you guys are well and playing. I will, of course, as usual, try to play some links about where you can get all of these map making software tools. For example, Camping Cartographer, you can buy directly on the developers page. Ill Winter's Floor Plan Generator and Dungeon Painter Studio, you can get on Steam, which is super easy to use. And you can get Dungeon Draft directly from Humble Bundle. Okay, and personally, all of these pieces of software, they are quite good, you know, but my favorites are CC3 and Dungeon Draft, for a lot of reasons. Dungeon Draft, because it's so easy. like I've shown you, it's extremely easy. Wow, so easy. And well, and CC3, because well, it's like, you know, this old car that you had when you were young, or this old piece of software, or this old piece of this old Nintendo or vintage game that you have, that you can just simply, you just can't throw away, because you know it has a lot of potential, but it's extremely quirky to use. But personally, again, just to make like a very short resume, if you are going to start making battle maps, which I believe is like a must when you play online, my whole recommendation, my wholehearted recommendation, goes with Dungeon Draft. Extremely easy to use. And I believe that in this day and age, the easier the better. And that's the whole thing about this whole video. Just show you what I use to make battle maps. And personally, Dungeon Draft is the safest bet. It's also very cheap. I think it's about 20 bucks. And just so that you can give those guys a look. They also have like a Discord channel. I'm going to try to place an invite here below the video. And again, as usual, I read everything that you guys send me. If you have any kind of question, any kind of request, any kind of insight or idea, or you just want to say hi, hey, please do it. I'm super receptive to that. I really love hearing about you guys and all of the things that you do and enjoy. And well, that's it. Thanks again for listening to these old man rambles for, I don't know, like an hour. Yeah, perhaps more than an hour. So thanks again to everybody, and have fun. And remember, subscribe. Bye, guys. Have fun.